tiny element of this great subject, which is the commemoration of this genocide, and also the negation of the genocide.
I have no time here to make it in details, but this
genocide, the genocide committed against the Armenian population, in difference with other genocides, is the subject of the official negationism of one of the states. I mean the Turkey.
So commemoration. And negation, or in fact negationism, as the state policy. As the state policy.
Commemoration. One of the great German writers, Franz Werfel, wrote a story, a book, about this Armenian genocide. 40 days of Musadak. Franz Werfel, one of the very prolific writers, and it's an epic story because Musadak was a mountain in Turkey. Near the Mediterranean Sea, where Armenian population, several thousands of them, effectively found refuge, and they were defending themselves against the Turkish soldiers, and then there came the French warship and put them to safe haven in France. And it was a very epic story, but in fact, Werfel wrote about the whole process of genocide. And for example, during the Second World War, in Jewish ghettos in Poland, Jewish ghettos established by the Germans in Poland, this book was very popular. There are several testimonies about that. For example, in Łódź, in Białystok, in several ghettos, Franz Werfel was widely read in this context of the possibility of the defending themselves against the mass destruction. And the new chapter in the commemoration took place, or is taking place nowadays. For example, as far as the recognition of the genocide character of this mass destruction, recognition by the state parliaments, for example, is concerned. For example, in 2005, the Polish parliament recognized officially the Armenian genocide, as the mass destruction of the whole population. And earlier and later, several other state parliaments, for example, in Belgium, in France, in Russia, but also European Parliament made several declarations about that. And the reaction of the Turkish state was a wave of protests against such declarations. For example, in 2000, the Turkish government cancelled the armament contract with the French government because the French parliament adopted the declaration which recognized the Armenian genocide. It's a historical fact, and it's a very interesting and but also very dramatic subject. This official negationism in Turkey, because Turkey adopted a policy which officially denies, still denying the truth about this genocide. For example, there are brave Turkish citizens who officially are protesting against such laws. For example, Orhan Pamuk, the Nobel Prize winner in the literature, have done that, and because of this fact, was also criticized in Turkish newspapers by the Turkish officials, and the so-called unknown attackers burned his car in Istanbul as a kind of penalty against him. So. This negationism of Turkish government, of the Turkish state, is indeed, for example, as far as the European Parliament is concerned, is viewed as one of the main obstacles in this process of integration, of possible integration of the Turkish state with the European Union. But as the initial question put by me on this blackboard teaches us that the keeping in mind the knowledge about the Armenian genocide is indeed very important, because when this knowledge is not transmitted, is not researched, then it's also an invitation, kind of invitation for other genocide activities. So, as far as I am concerned, that's all. There are a few minutes left, and I would like to hear, for example, some questions or some remarks about this subject, if you have ones. Thank you very much.
I really like your lecture, it's very interesting. I wonder today, how did you learn about the genocide in school in Turkey?
Yeah, in Turkey, for example, in Turkish school books, the courses on history, they are so constructed that the Armenians are shown as a kind of traitors, spies. For example, the mass destruction of this population is not mentioned. For example, in school books they write about that it was normal during the such a great war that there were mass deportations of citizens, because the front lines were moving ahead and back, so many.